G'day everyone, and welcome to Monday, week 7, the 7th week of 2023. It's the 6th of February 2023, and you are watching Movie Madness Monday on...
You mean Fatman? This is...
Fatman.
This is Candy Cars, and also doing the Movie Madness Monday.
That's right, and what else are we going to be doing today?
Rainbow Friends with the
Blocks. Do you want to do some Rainbow Friends with the Blocks?
We're going to do that first.
Okay, let's do that first. All right, but before we do anything, how about we get what we normally start with, something amazing that happened today. What's something amazing happened to you today, Captain Carwash?
Wow. I spent in my kinder.
Yeah?
And I spent in my kinder... my teacher.
You know, remember what your teacher's name is?
Yes.
What's your teacher's name?
It's
not Kinder Lady. What's your teacher's name?
My teacher's name is...
Nadia.
Nadia.
Okay, and something amazing happened to me today. Yep, the little fellow with the kinder did really, really well, and you also did swimming as well.
Yeah.
And did really, really well. High fives. All right. Now, what we're also going to do next is what I'm, again... for the 433rd day in a row, not prepared for, we're going to do the...
That one is the Don't Know You.
The Don't Know You's, that's right. Yeah, more way, IMDb. All right, this is all thanks to IMDb. We've got the Don't Know You. So Hugh was born today, the 6th of February, 2023. And guess what?
What?
I don't know you. I don't know you. I don't know you. Don't know you. Don't know you. Oh, Kathy Naimi from Sister Act. Turned 66 today. Happy birthday. Rip Torn, who passed away in 2019. It would have been his birthday today. Happy heavenly birthday. Don't know you. 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 Oh, lots of don't know yous today. Keep going through. Keep going through. Keep going through. Keep going through with the don't know yous. Keep going through with the don't know yous. Keep going through with the don't know yous. Okay, and now we're going to do our favorite three-year-old weather person. You're going to tell everyone what the weather is for the rest of this week. Okay, so let's get the weather started. Melbourne weather for this weekend, thanks to the Bureau of Meteorology with Melbourne. That's right. We live in Melbourne. So starting tomorrow after an overnight low of 13, it's going to be 20 degrees and?
Raining.
No. What's the weather going to be tomorrow? Partly cloudy. Then on Wednesday after an overnight low of 14, it's going to be 23 degrees and?
Cloudy and sunny.
That's right. And then 27 and mostly sunny on Thursday. 27 and mostly sunny on Friday. And then after an overnight low of 16 on Saturday, it's going to be 27 degrees and?
Cloudy.
That's right. And then on Sunday, 20 degrees and?
Cloudy.
And then on Monday, 19 degrees and?
Cloudy.
Lots and lots of partly cloudies. All right. So we'll be back after this very short break with the box office results for this week. Did Avatar get dethroned? I don't know. We'll have a look. And also some Rainbow Friends with the Blocks. You're watching Jimmy and the Fat Man Movie Madness Monday.
I'm going to do Rainbow Friends with the Blocks first.
We are going to do that. Now, before we get to the box office takings for the week and some Rainbow Friends with the Blocks, we'll get the formalities out of the way. And don't forget, Jimmy and the Fat Man, proudly brought to you by DF Insurance Services for your home, car, and business insurance needs. Will you go away? Head to dfiservices.com.au and we'll give you a no-obligation quote. We might give you a better deal, but we'll definitely give you better coverage. And also Full of Heart Music Studios. Head to fullofheartmusicstudios.com.au. And Mama Bear, we will give you some awesome either singing, piano, guitar, or violin lessons. It's now week 3 of 2023, so away we get started. Now, as we always do, we choose a fun background thanks to pixabay.com. This one brought to you by Julian Tremore. If you need some really cool backgrounds for your videos, hit the pixabay.com. And this is someone giving another guy a present, another person a present, because today is National Pay Compliment Day. So make sure you tell everyone how awesome they are, which is what a compliment is.
Which background you choose?
This one. It's someone giving someone a present. So it's someone telling someone else how awesome they are.
Well, what's his name?
Let's call him Juju. Juju is telling you how awesome you are, okay? You are awesome at swimming. Well done, Captain Car Wash. High five. You say something nice about Daddy?
Yeah.
Go.
I'm nice to me.
I'm nice to you. Beautiful. There we get started. All right. So let's get started with the box office results for the week. All right. So yes, Knock at the Cabin did dethrone Avatar The Way of Water. In fact, two movies did. So Knock at the Cabin from Universal Pictures grossed $14 million. 80 for Brady went to number two at $12.5 million. Avatar The Way of the Water is at $11 million. It took another $11 million for a total gross of $636.5 million. Puss in Boots took another $8 million for $151. BTS, yet to come in cinemas, a tick over $6 million on debut. A Man Called Otto at four. Megan fell two spots with another $3.5 million, missing $3.5 million. The Chosen season three, episode one and two, another $3.5 million. Oh, actually, that must have got a new release. Well done. And then rounding out the top 10 is Pathaan, with $2.8 million this week from Yaj Raz Films USA Inc. with $14 million. In total. All right, so let's have a look. Were there any other debuts? Yes, Let It Be Morning debuted at number 28 with $6,000 in two screens, which actually is the highest. No, it's not. That's its total gross. Yeah, $6,000. Hang on a second, darling. And Full Time from Music Box Films is $2,000 for the week. All right, so guess what we're doing now?
What?
Rainbow Friends with the Blocks. We'll be back with some Rainbow Friends with the Blocks. Now, you all know the deal with Rainbow Friends with the Blocks. You're given a little task every single level. What do we do first night? We have to find the
blocks
and escape from
Blue.
Night number two, we have to find the That's right, and escape from blue and
orange.
No, green.
Green.
Okay, night number three, we have to find the
oxygen.
That's right, and we have to escape from blue, green, and
orange.
That's right, and then night number four, we have to find the That's right, and you do it in the dark. And then night number five is the final lesson. So can we complete? We've already finished it twice. Can we do it a third time? We've now got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven of us.
Dad, when we do another night, it's birthday.
Yeah, that's right. In fact, so the next birthday is my birthday. Hey, Google, how many days until March 30?
My box for long
time. 31st of March 2020.
52 days.
Now you can do and put them back. No, man. Good luck.
All right. We'll be with you. Hang on. Just wait. Just wait. Just wait. All right. Let's go.
Why did you have to call? Who's not here? Who's here?
I think I can hear him. I can hear him.
Who's gonna get you in the box?
Oh, turn around. One.
Do you have a hand dryer there?
No hand dryer, buddy.
Just a shower?
Just a shower.
Why do you have a dish of shower in this here?
That was a design.
Look, he's shaking his booty.
He's shaking his booty, that's right. Shake, 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 diddy, shake, shake, shake. Take your booty.
Take your booty.
Oh, there's another block there. So we're going to drop the first three blocks. Oh, there's blue. You can hear him.
Who's going to get you in the box?
Blue can only get you in the box if he sees you go inside the box. Another two, so we've dropped the only five boxes so far. I think I heard Mama Bear here. Oh, someone's been found. Miss Lissy 321 has been found. I think we're right now. Must have dropped the only 6 blocks so far. It's just been us so far, Captain Car Wash.
Oh.
Good work.
I don't
want our
boy to get me in the box.
Neither do I. Anything in here? Nope. Looks like we've now found 20, so someone's done a big box drop. Oh, hang on, we've got a block. Where'd that block come from? Oh, someone else has been found. Ida Patrick 18 was found.
He got dead.
He found someone, that's right.
Why he got dead?
I'm not sure.
This game's very nice, I think.
All right, so we've now dropped another one. That's our 6th.
I like this game.
I know you do. This is your favorite game, isn't it?
It is.
Keep going. 3 more to go.
Purple hides in there.
Yeah.
Or purple don't hide in.
Yeah, not on this level. Hides in night 3.
Why she hides in a drag?
Because it's sneeze, sneeze, sneeze. What is he?
Sneaky, sneaky.
And that's it. That's night 1 done. We're back with night 2. You're watching Jimmy and the Fat Man playing...
Number
4. Oh, you're such a sweetheart. I love you too, baby boy. All right, so there's 5 of us left.
I am in the... Now in the... Shh. Who's not here? Why did it do?
Oh, Blue's getting straight into it.
Lucky! It was lucky!
Alright, there's a food pack. Oh no. Oh no, there's green! Box me quick! No, don't box me yet. Oh no! Oh no, we're in trouble now. We're trapped. Oh no! We got trapped! Well, doesn't matter. All right. We'll be back with now the movie trailers for Movie Madness Monday. I can't believe they trapped us. All right. Now we're done with the Rainbow Friends with the blocks. So let's get into some trailers. And the first trailer we're going to show you is, because obviously there's another Fast and Furious movie coming out, Fast 10. This is Fast and Furious Legacy trailer. Let's give this one a watch.
You sure you want to do this?
A lot has changed.
You're right.
Do you know each other?
He used to date my sister.
Oh no, not dumb, not dumb.
Welcome to Mexico, boys.
This is where my jurisdiction ends.
And this is where mine begins. I'm Angela, what happens next?
Going in there is suicide. Ride or die, remember?
Just like old times.
All right, so that was pretty cool. Don't forget to let me know what you think down in the comments. All right, next trailer we're going to be showing is the new trailer for Dungeons and Dragons Honor Among Thieves. All right, let's get it started.
Here's the thing. We're a team of thieves.
And when you do this, you're bound to make enemies.
Sometimes those enemies come looking for revenge.
Hey,
Truth be told, we helped the wrong person steal the wrong thing. We didn't mean to unleash the greatest evil the world has ever known. But we're gonna fix it.
Well, how do we pull that off?
Figure it out over a drink?
Probably best.
You need Kool-Aid!
Give us a fighting chance. We're gonna need strength. You got this, right?
I know you don't.
We also need courage. Magic. And you.
What is that again? It's an owl bear.
Let's go!
Be warned. There is evil here.
I'm glad he's on our side.
This one's dangerous. But whatever happens, we'll be ready.
What is it exactly that you bring to this?
I'm a planner. I make plans.
You've already made the plan, so...
If the existing plan fails, I make a new plan.
So you make plans that fail?
No.
He also plays the lute.
Not relevant.
Okay, so Dungeons and Dragons Honor Among Thieves is a fantasy adventure comedy film directed by Jonathan Goldstein and John Francis Daly, who co-wrote the screenplay based on the tabletop role-playing games. Dungeons and Dragons, it's set in the Forgotten Realms campaign setting and has no connection to the film trilogy released between 2000 and 2012. It stars Chris Pine, Michelle Rodriguez, Reege Jean-Page, Justice Smith, Sophia Lillis, and Hugh Grant. A group of thieves travel to a realm to stop a great evil from enslaving the world. Okay, so there you have it. All right, the next movie we're going to show is Guy Ritchie's The Covenant.
John, you have tellies approaching.
You still don't remember a thing.
I don't remember any of it.
I only remember the interpreter.
Why you want this job?
I need the money.
Don't disappoint, turn out to be a pain in the ass.
No,
not me, sir.
Money isn't the reason he wants this job. It's Alabama killed his son.
Stop the vehicle, Sergeant.
We don't want to go down this road.
You're out of your bounds, Ahmed. You're here to translate.
Actually, I'm here to interpret.
John, you have tellies approaching.
Well, I'm back down.
For 3 weeks, this family believed you were dead. We owe that man your life.
There wasn't enough for him to carry me across those mountains. Now he's hiding in a hole somewhere. I should be in that hole.
You could send me up at the gates of hell.
Everything all right, John?
No, everything's not all right. There is a hook in me. Ahmed and his family are in trouble.
We can't intervene.
I am gonna have to get him out myself.
Listen,
you're gonna be alone.
There ain't no reason.
You gotta adapt. Here's what you got.
If you can give me the location, if I can get him out of the country,
it's too dangerous.
You'll become very popular with the Taliban.
I miss you.
Love you, Daddy.
Love you, Daddy.
You think if I could be free of this debt, I would be? You think I have a choice? There is no choice.
No, I won't back down.
Okay, I have to admit, I'm psyched to watch that movie. I am absolutely psyched to watch that movie. That is The Covenant. It's an upcoming action thriller, co-written, co-produced, and directed by Guy Ritchie, starring Jake Gyllenhaal and Dar Salim. It'll be released theatrically 21st of April 2023. And as you can see, it looks like so a guy gets saved, then the guy who saves him gets captured, and now Jake Gyllenhaal is going to go back in there and save him. That looks amazing! I cannot wait for that to come out. That is the recommendation so far, Guy Ritchie's The Covenant. All right, we're now going to have a look at God's Time. Is it God's Time? Is that the trailer? Sorry, give me a sec. God's Time. All right, let's have a look. Pause button.
Call me back.
Talking to you right now. Let's just get one thing straight. I am not the hero of this story. That's me, Dev. And I'm absolutely in love with this woman. No one is ever gonna come between us. In case you didn't know, this is a meeting for addicts in recovery.
I scream at my mother. I fight with my brothers. None of it is enough. My ex-boyfriend kicked me out of my own place and took my dog, Baranda. So you know what? I'm gonna kill him.
Yo! Ah! Wait! He's gonna kill Russell!
She was just sharing. People share to grow, to vent.
Just because you got a crush on her, maybe you're reading
what?
Too much.
Bro, it's not about a crush, okay?
Maybe you're getting a little.
We're doing something together. We're trying to save somebody.
Ma'am.
Yeah. Yes, yes.
Feels better?
My mom hates me. You gotta talk to her. Say your Manuel.
Manuel!
Stop
it! My name is Manuel. Is your daughter Rio?
What are we gonna do? We're just two regular people.
Why do you idiotas keep thinking I need saving?
Feeling dejected by reality, although God's Time does not treat COVID, it may alleviate isolation, longing for human contact, and lack of purpose.
Smells like leche podrida. Like rotten milk.
All right, how about you two mooks over there? Come on up here and get a hug.
No, sir. Very, very good. Thank you.
Come on. Keep coming back.
What exactly do you think is going on?
Keep coming back.
You're desperate.
Keep coming back.
And we only manipulate when we're desperate, right?
Keep coming back. Keep coming back.
I have faith he'll die in God's time.
God's time.
God's time.
Hey, I love you.
Okay. I'll be back.
You're my boy.
No, Sam.
I love you. I appreciate you.
Who's he?
That's my assistant, Manuel.
Hey, Manuel.
I'm sorry.
Hola, Manuel.
If you win, you won't be.
All right, so that was In God's Time. All right. Now, the final trailer that I'm going to be showing you is called 88. Really out there sort of movie produced by Charlemagne the God. And I'm really keen to see what you think about this. Is 88.
If you win, you won't be the first black president. That changed the way you'll govern?
I want to give them the tools to be self-sufficient so they don't have to rely on us.
Let water find its own level.
Isn't that true equality?
We are one USA. We have raised more money faster than any other Democratic super PAC this election cycle. And we won't slow down until Harold Roundtree is in the White House.
I supported you taking that job. Maybe you would help that campaign focus on the real issues.
I've been analyzing contributions to our super PAC, and I started to see patterns.
Patterns?
They're all add-ins of the same number.
What number?
88.
All of it. Goes back to business interests associated with one organization.
We need to get ahead of this.
We're sitting on the time bomb.
Where do we start? Follow the money?
I don't think they're expecting to run into Black Rain Man.
White supremacists supporting a black man. You know how ridiculous that sounds?
It goes way beyond campaign funds.
It goes to the soul of the country.
Bury this. We never know.
You stumbled on something far bigger than you think, Mr. Jackson.
I'm scared that one day our son could walk out that door and never make it back home.
8701-2563-71.17.
I am the architect of my destiny.
There's a storm coming, Mr. Jackson. Stay out of the way.
Mr. Jackson, I know who I am.
All right, that was 88, a deep dive into American politics, associated conspiracy theories. It's quite a rabbit hole, truly crazy, mind-blowing and frightening stuff. Been given an 8.7 out of 10 on IMDb, so really keen for that to get a wide release. With William Fichtner, Thomas Sadowski, Nduri Norton, Kenneth Choi, Orlando Jones, Kelly McCreary, Michael Harney, and a lot more. So looking forward to seeing when that, I don't even know what's out yet. All right, now final bit of Movie Madness Monday is the news. Okay, so over to some movie news. Michael Jackson's nephew Jafar to play Michael Jackson in a new biopic. A couple of weeks ago, word arrived that Antoine Fuqua would direct a biopic of controversial music megastar Michael Jackson. And now it's announced that Jafar Jackson, the son of Michael's brother Jermaine, is actually going to be playing Michael Jackson in said movie. Let's have a look. Jackson, who was the son of Michael's brother Jermaine, has established a social media presence as a talented singer and dancer, but this role would seem to be fraught with controversy, and if the team behind the film sought to defuse that in any way, casting one of Jackson's extended family would not seem to be the best option. Oh, good stuff. Film and Passion Project, the producer Graham King and writer John Logan aim to chart Jackson's rise to fame, his troubled family life, his music career, but not ignoring his chaotic personal life, plastic surgery, and the pedophile accusations that dogged his latter years up to his death in 2009, age 50. The film, simply titled Michael, at this point, is likely to begin filming this year. I don't know what, provided that it is not like those other disgusting movies, I watched this movie 26,000 times. Okay, all right. In other news, Julia Roberts and Jennifer Aniston are starring in a body swap comedy. Time-looping comedy Palm Springs took a while to make it over, but it was worth the wait. So naturally, there is a new one. Little else known about the movie beyond the fact that Barbara Cow came up with the concept and wrote the script and she'll direct. It is snagged to deal with Amazon and will be produced by Robert's company and Margot Robbie's Lucky Chap Entertainment. So it'd be interesting to see what that is about. It's interesting for a woman to swap with a woman. Normally, it's, boy swaps with girl, that sort of thing. So let's see what that one's about. Okay, and last on this list, with Creed 3 on the way next month, it appears that Michael Jordan, who both stars in and directs this entry, has an eye in the future, and he's confirmed that a fourth movie will be happening for sure. Now, Creed 3 finds Jordan's Adonis doing well in his boxing career, but facing off against a childhood friend who, after finishing a prison sentence, wants to return to the ring. So let's have a look whether it comes out. It's coming out on the 3rd of March. Will it succeed enough for them to do a fourth movie? We're not 100% sure. We'll see how it goes. All right, well, look, that's it for me tonight on Jimmy and the Fat Man. It's been an absolutely pleasure having you on. Thank you for joining. Thank you for watching. We're trying to get to 1,000 subscribers so that we can begin to monetize the channel. Not for the money side of things, but it would really, really, really mean a lot to Jimmy. So really, if you could share this video and tell your friends about it, comment, subscribe, and that way you can share around the internet. We'd really love it, and lots and lots and lots of gratitude if you can do so. So thank you very much. So in the road to 1,000 subscribers, that's it for me. Hope you have a wonderful night. Join us for tomorrow for Wonderlist Tuesday. From my family to yours, peace. Good night.